Les services écosystémiques sont
ecosystemic
les services
are the services rendered by ecosystems for
ville,
human beings. Even in town, these services are essential for town dwellers' life. Healthy ecosystems are the basis for sustainable life. They play an essential role for the well-being of town dwellers, and they play an essential role in many economic activities. The first service we may discuss is the supply service, whereby nature in town may produce vegetables or fruit to feed people living in town. But for this service to take place, the soil must be healthy with air and good quality water. The second service is regulation. Vegetation in town can absorb part of the gases, polluting gases released into the atmosphere. It can also clean the soil and improve water quality because water is filtered through the ground. Another service rendered by the ecosystem is temperature decrease obtained with green areas. In town, we have what we call the heat island phenomenon because buildings release at night the temperature stored during the day because of sun rays, and green areas tend to mitigate the phenomenon. You can feel it already when you walk in streets with trees on both sides. You can walk in the shade and obviously the temperature is much lower. If you look at this picture taken in Paris one evening during the summer, on the left-hand side we can see the green areas in the buildings. On the right-hand side we see the difference in temperature between the buildings and the green area, the lawns and gardens, which means that we must have more green spaces, green areas in town. During the heat waves, mortality was higher in the building areas rather than in the blocks where there were many gardens and green areas. One other very useful service in town is a cultural service provided by biodiversity. It is much nicer to rest or walk or jog in areas where there is more biodiversity versus concrete-clad areas where obviously biodiversity is not available, it doesn't render any services. The last ecosystemic service which proves useful in town and that we must pay attention to is the support service that allows all of the other services to be available. On the left-hand side, we see a nest with birds, and by welcoming birds, the urban spaces allow the birds to regulate populations of small mammals and insects, some of which may be pests, and this may control outbreaks of pests. Another support service is pollination, which is absolutely essential to grow vegetables or fruit. Now, pollination. Let us focus on pollination for a few minutes. We tried to understand how this was spread in town and how far pollination was possible in the various areas. We took the data from a participative science program called Wild Species in My Street, and citizens provide data regarding the species they find in their own gardens. An autogamous plant is a plant that may reproduce itself by producing its own ova and gametes, and this is the case for daisies. Some plants are allogamous. It means that it takes two plants to produce the ovum and the pollen, and the insects may carry the pollen, or in some cases the wind. But some plants also have a mixed regime. They normally encourage allo fertilization, reproduction between two different individuals. But if there is no wind or there are no insects to carry the pollen, then they revert to self fertilization. And thanks to this program, we were able to establish that in the center of town, plants are much more autonomous for their reproduction than outside of the town in the very urban areas. So pollination takes place in more easily in the suburban areas. If you want to grow a vegetable garden, it's easier to do so outside of town in the peri-urban area rather than in the center of town. All of the work conducted has shown that services rendered by biodiversity in town are numerous and absolutely essential for the life of town dwellers, and it's essential that biodiversity is preserved at all levels of the urban territory so that human beings living in towns can benefit from those services.